500 million. This is the number of tweets that are posted every single day. That's a pretty huge number, right? You can track discussions related to your brand or your product. You can track discussions related to your competitors. And you can keep an eye on new trends as soon as they are emerge on day one. For you, the best deal is to have access to tweets on a daily basis without spending too much time on it. And this is why you will learn how to script tweets on Twitter. You can do it for free with Octoparse. The link to download it is in the info box. My name is François and welcome to this tutorial. Today, we will scrape 100 tweets from the Elon Musk account. So you copy the URL of your Twitter search and you paste it in Octoparse. We are in the home page, we paste it and we click on start. The first thing I need to do is to create a loop item in order to scrape a couple of tweets. So I turn off the browse mode and I select the block of the first tweet. Then I click on select sub-elements, select all and extract data. And as you can see, the loop item has just been created. Of course, I need to delete some columns because I've got like 17, 18 columns. I delete the unnecessary column and I just keep the ones I need. For instance, I want to extract 6 different elements. The name, the date, the content of the tweet, of course, the number of comments, retweets, and likes. For instance, this column is useless. I'm going to delete it. Same thing for that one. Here is the result. As you can see, I've got the name, I've got the date, I've got the number of comments, the number of retweets, and the number of likes. There is one more thing I need to extract. It is the content of the tweet. So I click on the content of the first tweet and I click and extract the text of the element. And there it is. There is one more thing I want to show you. It is related to the date. Because look, it's written that this tweet has been published 45 minutes ago. Well, it doesn't show me what's the date today. So to get the real publishing date, I need to click on more and customize fields, extract attribute and date time. And as you can see, now we've got the real publishing date. The first step is to create a pagination. Because look, Twitter applies here what we call the infinite scrolling technique, which means that in order to scrape more content, to scrape more tweets, we need to scroll down to the bottom of the page. So we scroll down to the bottom of the page, we extract data, we scroll down, we extract data, and so on and so forth. To create a pagination, I click on the side of the screen, and I click on loop click single element. And as you can see, I've got my pagination. I immediately need to change the settings. So I go to options and I will set up an Ajax timeout of 5 seconds. Then I click and scroll down the page after it's loaded. I select for one screen with a waiting time of let's say 2 seconds this time. And I will only scroll down the page one time and I click on apply. As you might have guessed, one time is not enough. So I select the pagination, I scroll down a little bit, and I will say that I want to repeat the process, let's say 1,000 times, basically as many times as possible. And I click on apply. Congratulations, because now your task is over. You just need to save your task if it's not already done, and to run your task. Then I click on run on your device. For this kind of task, I strongly suggest you to open it on full screen because it will help you to scrape more tweets. As you can see, we've got a lot of duplicates, but that's fine. We just need to remove them. So I click remove duplicates and I export the result in an Excel spreadsheet. And here is what your result should look like. This is the end of the video. If you don't know much about Octoparse, you can check our beginner guide in the info box. And if you enjoy this kind of video, you can subscribe before you go. See you next week. Hope my video got your confusion cleared away. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos regarding Octoparse and web scraping. We will always keep you updated.